starts the definitive care, the phase 2. What happens in initial days, the treatment of fracture was considered successfully by the mere union of the bone. The bone is united, good. The fracture is good. The treatment of fracture is successful. It's done. But nowadays, there are so many objectives and a doctor have to keep in mind while treating the fracture. The first one is, of course, there should be a union. So union, whether the limb or the part is cosmetically normal or not. And all after this, whether the part is functioning like pre-traumatic part. Like whether it's functioning before, how it is functioning, and is it as good as it was functioning before the fracture. All this objective you have to keep in mind while treating the fracture. So there are the changes in fracture treatment. What is done in intra-articular fracture means the fracture in joint or in which involves the joint. You have to stabilize the joint. You have to reduce the fracture. You have to fix the immobilize the part. But you have to mobilize the part as soon as possible. Because if you keep a joint immobilized for a long period of time, what is going to happen? There will be stiffening of joint and there will be of wasting of muscles. Right? So what we are going to do? We are going to reduce, fix and mobilize as soon as possible. Then diaphyseal fracture or the fracture of shaft. Right? You need to fix it. You need to reduce it. But while reducing, you have to see whether it is aligned or not. Whether the height of both the limbs normal or not. What happens, one limb is shorter and one limb is longer? It is not cosmetically acceptable. It is not acceptable by the patient. So you have to see whether the alignment is proper or not, whether there is malalignment or not. And after all this, you have to mobilize the limb as soon as possible, because if you keep the immobilization for longer period, there will be wasting of muscle. So objectives are changed. The initial treatment and now the modern treatment has changed a lot. We have another lecture for the what are the modern techniques for treatment of fractures, but this is just a gross idea. Okay, now we are going to see the fundamental principle for treatment of fracture. So there are three fundamental features for treating the fracture. The first one is the reduction. You have to proximate the two fracture end. That is immobilization. You have to keep that reduced ends together. And then the preservation of the functions. What if the part is not functioning? It is unioned, it is looking good, but you are not able to move your hand. It's not acceptable. So these are the three fundamental functions principles you have to keep in mind while treating the fracture. Now let us first see the definitions and then we are going to see these principles in detail. The first one is reduction. Reduction is a technique of setting a displaced fracture in proper alignment. Alignment means everything. If your foot is fractured, you are not going to put it, like if this is your foot and it gets fractured, it is not acceptable that you aligned it 180 degree. You have to align with angle, with plane and cosmetically. So reduction is a technique of setting the displaced fracture in proper alignment. You can reduce it by opening the fracture or closing them in the closed condition. So there are two methods for reducing the fracture. The first one is a closed reduction and the second one is open reduction. What are these? We are going to see in detail. Immobilization. It is necessary to maintain that reduced end in that constant stage. If the fracture is frequently moving, how is it going to unite? If the fracture is like this, there has a part union and it moved. Again, there is injury. Again, it will move in another direction. There can be either the case of non-union or there can be the case of angulation. And both are not accepted. So there is a need to immobilize the patient. And there are, first of all, is the internal fixation. And then is the external fixation. Right? Then the last principle is preservation of function. physiotherapy throughout the fracture treatment and even when the limb is immobilized is necessary to restore the proper functioning of the limb. See what happens, these are the principle, fundamental principles, but there are some fracture which does not require all of these principles to be followed. One principle is followed, the fracture is uniting. So we are going to see these other methods for treatment. The first one is treatment by the functional use of limb. See, the fractures of rib, the fracture of ribs and the scapula does not require immobilization. A mere reduction, splinting and painkillers is enough to treat the fracture. For few days, give the patient the bed rest. After few days, ask him, you can do whatever thing, you can do the normal work and the fracture is going to heal. So that fracture is a fracture of ribs or fracture of scapula. Then is treatment by mobilization alone. See, there are some fractures which has not grossly displaced, like the fracture of surgical neck of humerus. It is just mere crack or thin hairline fracture. So it does need only painkillers and mobilization, does not need reduction. So that is fracture of neck of humerus. Then treatment by close reduction and immobilization. The fracture, the treatment of close reduction means you are not opening the fracture. So you are going to treat the fracture by close reduction and you are going to immobilize it. The example for this is, let me see once. Without opening, you are going to reduce the fracture. You are going to carry it out in general anesthesia and you are going to apply the cast. Any normal fracture which is not grossly distressed can be done by this. Then is close reduction and subcutaneous fixation. What you are going to do, you are going to reduce it non-surgically. So non-surgical reduction. But you are going to fix it by percutaneous fixation, means we are going to use K wire. What is K wire? There is further, we just have the example K wire, or you are going to use screw, nails, plates, whichever necessary percutaneous fixation, you are going to use it here. See, these close reduction and percutaneous fixation is done in the interarticular fractures because mobilization of joint is important. If you are going to put a huge cast on the person, that person is going to lay on bed for next 6 months. It can give lot many complications like stiffening of joint, wasting of muscles, bed sores, or there is loss of physical activity of that part, then embolism, lot many complications. So your work is to mobilize the patient as soon as possible. And if you can keep him or her mobilized in the period of treatment, it's well and good. So close reduction. Then is open reduction and internal fixation. This open reduction and internal fixation is done when you have open fracture or you have RTAs or which has gross deformities, or both of the ends are dislocated from each other so badly that you need to open the fracture, you need to treat it, you need to put wires, pins, rods and nails to get it in place. That is MIS. This MIS is minimal invasive surgery. So a mere cuts, a small length cuts of 3 to 4 mm is given to put the wires or the screws and to stabilize the patient, stabilize the fracture. So what you are going to do, you are going to do the close reduction. You are not going to open the fracture. You are going to reduce the fracture with non-surgically, and then you are going to put a small incision, going to put wires or screws and fix the bone. Okay, so all these are the other methods for treatment. So first of all, the reduction. We are going to see the reduction and then we are going to see the immobilization. So what are the indication for reduction? If two ends are closely in close contact with each other, if two fractures ends and fractured end is in close contact with each other, there is no need of reduction. There will be healing of bone on its own. Like the fracture of clavicle of the person, baby, you need not to reduce. It will heal on itself. But there are some fractures which are grossly displaced. You need to reduce that fracture. And with the reduction of fracture, you need to keep in mind the alignment and cosmetic result. So, the fracture which are grossly displaced, and you need to take care of alignment, right? So what are the methods for reduction? There are three methods of reduction. The first is a close manipulation, then is continuous traction, and then is open reduction. So what you are going to do in close manipulation, you are not going to open the fracture. You are going to feel the fracture end through the soft tissue, and you are going to manipulate in it and bring the two closed end together. This is done under general anesthesia. And image intensifier. With the help of image intensifier, you're going to guide yourself and reduce the fracture in closed condition. And after the reduction of the fracture, you're going to immobilize the part by putting cast and slings. Okay, then is continuous traction. What happens in some cases or in some bones, the powerful muscles are inserted on that fractures. So when you reduce the end, it is reduced. But after some time, because of pull of powerful muscle, they get dislocated again, displaced again. When you again reduce it, it will again displace. This is the reason is the powerful muscles. Take a fracture of shaft of femur. Hamstrings, powerful muscles are inserted on that. So whenever you reduce those end, it will displace. So what we have to do in traction, continuous traction, if the muscle is pulling this way, you are applying the traction opposite to you and making the bone comes to its normal position. So by the continuous pull against the muscle, you are gonna nullify the effect, the pull on the bone, and you are going to make those two ends in close contact with each other. So, but what happens is that putting the continuous traction, putting so much of cast on the patient, you immobilize the patient for next 6 months. And this can have lot many complications. Initially this method was preferred, but nowadays it is not preferred. We go for open reduction and external fixation, right? Initially this continuous traction was accepted, but now we are moving towards the modern treatment, open reduction and external fixation. So what you do in open reduction, when these types of fracture occurs, which are continuously getting displaced from the parts, or there is commuted fracture, gross displacement, we are going to open the fracture, we are going to put screws and plate, and we are going to reduce the fracture, and we are going to close it, put the external fixator, and let it heal for next 6 months. What will happen in this? The joint of the patient will be mobilized. There will be minimal twisting. But there is one biggest, what we can say, disadvantage of doing the open reduction. That is, whenever you put a foreign body in some part, there is high chances of infection. And trust me, you don't want your patient's bone to be infected. The infection of bone is so bad that if the antibiotic is not working, you have to amputate the limb. So you don't want infection in the person's bone. So these are the open reduction techniques. Then let us move towards the immobilization. What are the indications for the immobilization? The first one is to prevent displacement, non-union and angulation of the fracture, to prevent the movement. If there is continuous movement between the two fractures, there will be non-union. Then to relieve the pain. If there is continuous movement, obviously nerve is going to excite and the person is going to have pain. So these are the indications for the immobilization. Now you have two methods for immobilization. First is non-operative, and then we have the operative. So what are the non-operative? The here we have the strapping. Let me see the spelling. It is strapping. So what is then? It is the phalanx fracture. If this finger is fractured, you are going to tape this finger with the healthy finger, and this finger, by taping to the affected finger, is going to provide the support, and this is just merely done by the tape. So you are going to, that's why it is strapping. Then we have the sling. See, this is the sling and this is the sling as well. This sling is used in the treatment of fracture of upper extremities. You can see it is used for the treatment of fracture of upper extremities, and it is mostly to relieve the pain, because there should be strict immobilization of that part. Then we have the cast immobilization. This is the cast. What is then cast immobilization? The plaster of Paris or gypsum salt is used. So what is the formula for gypsum salt? It is CaSO4 by half molecule of water. But when you use put water in it and you are going to make the gypsum salt mixture, as you add the water, the two molecules of water get attached to it, and then you get the formula as CaSO4 by 2H2O. But this reaction is exothermic. What is it? It's exothermic, which means when you add water to the gypsum salt, it is going to liberate the heat. And as the heat is liberated, and when you apply that plaster, this plaster of Paris on the bandage, it is going to harden as it cools down. So what are the types of plaster bandage used? The first one is you are going to take the plaster of Paris, and you are going to take a starch cotton bandage, and you are going to put this bandage and then plaster the bandage and this plaster, and you are going to create the cast. Or you have the proprietary bandage in market as well. Then there are two types. First one, you have slabs and you have cast. So what is different between slab and cast? Actually, the slab is a layer of bandage and the plaster of Paris. What you are going to do, you are going to take this slab and going to roll into and fro motion on the table, and you are going to cover only, not the whole part, 3/4 part of the limb, and you are going to keep some part of the limb open. In this image, can you see, this is the slab and this part is open. And after applying this slab and keeping this part open, you are going to cover it with crepe bandage. Right, so in this way you apply the slab, and in this image you are going to see there is whole part is closed, and this is the cast. This one is the cast and this one is the slab. Okay, did you appreciate the difference between slab and the cast? Now this slab is 12 layers thick, but the cast, you can change the thickness. You can have thin cast and thick cast as per the need for the immobilization. Then you are going to see this functional bracing. See, can you appreciate that this part is movable, and here even this part is movable, that the knee is movable and there is a movement between this ankle. So this cast is helpful to prevent the stiffening of the joints of affected limb. See, already you are having injuries to the muscles. There is going to have some stiffening in the joint, and keeping that immobilized is going to increase the stiffening of the joint. So here you are trying to give somewhat mobilization to the joint so it has less stiffening. Then we have the operative method. In operative method, we have the internal fixation and then we have the external fixation. So what happens in internal fixation, as you have seen in the minimal invasive surgery, you are going to put a small incision and you are going to put the steel wire, K wire, and going to fix it. So in internal fixation, the fixating material is inside. It has no communication with the external environment, or at least communication with the external environment. You are going to fix the close reduction of the, you are going to do the close reduction of the fracture and then going to internally fix it. So what all things you are going to use? You are going to use steel wires, K wires, internal medullary ring, screws, plate, and Then you have the external fixation. So what happens in external fixation is that this, see, this is the straight fixation, what you call it as pin fixator. Pin fixator, and this one is a ring fixator. You must have been appreciated why the name is so. These are the pins, and this one is straight, but here you have rings over here. Hence it is called as a ring fixator. So what happens is that a fixator is outside and you are putting those pins. See, this is the fixator outside and this is the pin. And here I have bones. So the pins are inserting in the bone and the fixator is outside. This is the pin fixator and this is the ring fixator. Pin fixator and the ring fixator. Now let us move towards the third phase, that is rehabilitation. See, you must be thinking that the process of rehabilitation starts after you remove the cast. No. The process of rehabilitation starts where there is treatment of fracture starts, or when the treatment, when the fracture occurs. See, I have said that you have to mobilize the patient as soon as possible. That is the thinking for the rehabilitation. That is like the thought process you are thinking about the rehabilitation. So you have joint mobilization and muscle re-education system. You have joint mobilization and muscle re-educating system. So in joint mobilization, you are going to mobilize the joint even when there is cast. If the joint is open and there is a cast, you are going to mobilize the joint. But what happens, the patient is in so tremendous pain that he or she is not going to move the limb on its own. It's the physiotherapist's work to give the passive movement to the joints and reduce its stiffening. So we call it as CPM, continuous passive motion. It is given by the physiotherapist to the patient, and when the patient is on its own, they can practice this actively. Then we have the muscle re-educating exercise. This is done after the removal of immobilization. The muscle has undergone this wasting. So by giving the regular exercise to the muscle is going to regain its condition which it was before the trauma. So all these are the fundamental principle for management of closed fracture. In next video, we are going to see the fundamental treatment of management for the from the open fracture, and we are going to see the types of open fracture 1, 2, 3A, 3B, 3C. So what are these? So stay tuned to my channel, and if you are still new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so you get notified every time I post a new video. Also, smash that like button if you like my video and comment down in the comment section below.